Black Hills Center, and a few others around the state. We have a handful of individuals that are volunteering as well, because they are as passionate about voting and LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit community as we are. So we're letting in a few more people. We'll kick it off right away with some tunes from our SODAC Pride playlist that we put together last year. And Natasha with Hot 104.7 graciously added some more music. Natasha's been a very strong ally to LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit people for many years. She was an MC at Sioux Falls Pride a couple years ago when I was involved. But yeah, I'll let her play the music.
All right, this is usually a crowd favorite, and you know, we could use some dancing, right?
So. Why not? And don't be afraid to dance.
Hot and dangerous. If you're one of us, then roll with us. Cause we make the hipsters fall in love when we got our hot pants on and up. And yes, of course we does. We run in this town just like a club. And no, you don't wanna mess with us. Got Jesus on my necklace. Got that glitter on my eyes. Stockings ripped all up the side. Looking sick and sexy. It's making my brain delirious. I'm just talking truth. I'm telling you about the shit we do. We're selling our clothes, sleeping in cars, dressing it down, hitting on dudes hard. Got that glitter on my eyes. Stockings ripped all up the side. Looking sick and sexy fied. So let's go, oh, oh. Let's go. Tonight we're going hard. Just like the world is ours. We're tearing it apart, apart. You know we're superstars. We are who we are. We're dancing like we're dumb. Our bodies go numb. We'll be forever young. Yum. You know we're superstars. We are who we are. DJ, turn it up.
Doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Just put your paws up, cause you were born this way, baby.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all on superstars. She pulled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Just be a queen. Don't be a drag. Just be a queen. Don't be a drag. Just be a queen. Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Subway can rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, respect my youth. A different law is not a sin, believe capital H I am. Hey, yeah. I know the love and love this brand could end. Me, I'm on it, rolling by you. Be a drag, just be a queen. Whether you're broke or evergreen, your black, white, beige, Chola descent, your Lebanese, your Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast or leader teased, rejoice and love yourself today, cause baby, you were born this way. No matter gay, straight or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white, or beige, Chola or Orient, mate, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born. Be brave.
That's basically it, if you want to go ahead. You told me one more song, so.
Perfect. Well, thank you, Natasha, for being our lovely, wonderful DJ. I'm trying to get this connected to our Facebook live stream, but it is being a little finicky right now. So one moment. Let's do... Not really. Okay, so it looks like we're live. Hello, everybody. Thank you for bearing with us with the technology this morning. Zoom can be a little tricky, it seems. But I'm glad you all are here. I'm glad that you all are tuning into what we're doing with the Vote Out campaign. Us at the ACLU and the Sioux Falls Pride, Black Hills Center for Equality, Equality South Dakota, and a handful of individuals are all volunteering together to reconnect LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit people with their power as voters in South Dakota. We know it's no secret that sometimes South Dakota could be a volatile place for LGBTQ plus people and Two-Spirit folks like us. So that's why we're reminding people that they have a power to change things as long as they show up at the ballot box. In November, in June, whenever there's an election, every single elected office, whether it's a city council member, a county commissioner, president of the United States, a governor, everybody has an impact on our elections. So I am going to get things kicked off here with our set of speakers. We have Cody Engel with Sioux Falls Pride, who's going to talk a little bit here, followed by Susan, and then someone from our office will speak. So Cody wants to kick it off.
Yes, hi everyone. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it, and we're super excited about the potential this has and getting people out to vote, especially this upcoming election. So yes, as Adam said, my name is Cody Engel. My pronouns are he, him, and his. I serve as the events coordinator on the board of Sioux Falls Pride, and I'm actually also running for state house in District 6 of South Dakota. So if you know anybody in District 6, send them my way. I need lots of money. on June 28th, so just a little history background. On June 28th, 1969, an uprising began at the Stonewall Inn in Manhattan. So after years of police brutality and mistreatment from judges and those in power, the LGBTQ plus and two-spirited community fought back against a corrupt system that was arresting, prosecuting, and beating them. This began a movement for equitable treatment and civil rights that we continue to fight for today. 1 year later, the first Pride, and every year after, commemorates this event. So June marks Pride Month across the globe, and even though Pride as a celebration has been postponed due to COVID-19, Pride is a continual movement across the world. Pride means empowerment. Pride means visibility. Pride means coming together as the LGBTQ plus and two-spirited community and celebrating who we are. Allies, you're of course included in this. We celebrate Pride for our community to show that we love who we are. In 2015, our community saw a great victory with the win of Obergefell v. Hodges and the passing of marriage equality nationwide. This year, we saw another momentous decision with the passing of extended Title VII rights to include sexual orientation and gender identity. While these victories were great, we still have much to go in the way of equitable treatment. In areas such as housing, adoption, and medical treatment, LGBTQ plus and two-spirited people still do not have protections against discrimination. The power we hold as voters in South Dakota is honestly very largely untapped. And on an almost annual basis, we see a litany of bills proposed by state lawmakers that purposefully target LGBTQ plus and two-spirited folks. Bills like House Bill 1215 and House Bill 1057 are prime examples of how our community is assaulted by our current crop of elected leaders and peer. Lawmakers should not be wasting their time on anti-LGBTQ plus and two-spirit bills. Something has to change, and that's where you come in. Local elections are vital. Your state senators and representatives, city councilors and commissioners have an unmistakable impact on how South Dakota operates. As voters, we should be the ones deciding who represents us and how, not the other way around. Now, I know that oftentimes voters feel disconnected in the political process, especially in South Dakota. We often hear this idea that my vote doesn't matter. However, I just want to encourage you that that is anything but true. Just look at this last primary election as an example. Some city council seats were decided by a margin of nearly 100 votes, and some legislative offices by far less. Imagine if those voters didn't show up, or on the flip side, if double that amount did. Our elected offices would look so much different, and our communities would be so much stronger. LGBTQ plus and two-spirit South Dakotans need elected leaders that will fight for equitable solutions to problems that face everyone in our community. Right now, it seems to be the opposite. So it's time for us to pay attention, to educate our choices at the ballot box, and vote out. We must embrace our power by raising our voices at the ballot box, because our ability to vote is right in front of many of us. We just need to act on it. I want to encourage everyone to research who is on your ballot, and to vote for those who will put equitable treatment for all first. It's time for us to vote out and to be visible. So let's make sure that South Dakota sees our community for what we are, loud and proud. We will be seen and heard in November. And it's with pride in our community and pride in ourselves that we will all win. Thank you.
Yay. Thanks, Cody. Next is one quick fun thing. We're giving away some t-shirts today. So Sioux Falls Pride Transformation Project and us at the ACLU are all giving away a couple shirts. So Natasha will announce the three lucky winners of some Sioux Falls Pride shirts.
Well, I feel like they should have to work for it a little bit. Like, who wants a pride?
Monica, you already have one.
Yeah, we'll go with Liz. Liz got very excited.
Yay.
There's another one. Come on.
You know, like Monica said, she could always use another one. Let's give her one too. And let's see, who else was like a little excited? Or maybe we'll pick someone just to get them excited. let's go with like Eric there, just because I'm yay!
Eric, yay!
You know, I'm just going to jump in. Monica, Liz, and Eric, I'm just going to message you in the chat to get your addresses. So we will send them out. And I'm not creepy. I'm Jana from the ACLU. So I'm not stalking to get your addresses. Totally legitimate. So.
Yes, Jana is a trustworthy representative of our office. Please give her your information. So next, we have another speaker from one of our partner organizations, Susan, with the Transformation Project. One of my favorite human beings on the planet is going to talk a little bit about why they are a part of this campaign and the power of your vote in South Dakota.
Thanks so much, Adam. It is so fun to be here with all of you today. How many of you all were standing out in the rain with us an hour and a half ago? Wasn't that amazing? It was a beautiful time. I was talking to my son when we woke up this morning, and I was like, oh, what a bummer. And he said, you know what? All of these people, we've been through so much. Like, what's a little bit of rain? And I agree. A little bit of rain is not going to stop us. So again, I'm Susan Williams. I am the founder and executive director of the Transformation Project. We are headquartered in Sioux Falls. And we became a nonprofit about a year ago. And our mission is to support and empower transgender youth, young adults, and their families while educating communities in South Dakota and the surrounding region about gender identity and expression. And we all know that transgender South Dakotans deserve better. Far too many transgender youth and young adults in our state and region have faced misunderstanding, hostility, and outright discrimination simply because of who they are. This has created a climate where kids live in fear of being their true selves, while parents desperate for community are increasingly isolated, and where vulnerable people feel powerless. We're determined to change that and turn our home into a place where communities embrace their transgender neighbors, where every family has a supportive network, and where transgender kids and young adults and adults can live safely and authentically. And our vision is one where every young person, every person that is trans or non-binary knows that they are loved, valued, and empowered to make their dreams reality. Now, I just got involved in the political process a few years ago, starting with some anti-trans legislation. I had never been to peer before. I had never really been too interested in the political process. And when my son came out as transgender, everything changed. I realized that there were legislators that were basically trying to make our lives a lot harder. And so I got involved. And one of the things that I learned is that a lot of people in South Dakota really don't get involved because we don't think that we can make a difference. And what I've found is that we're such a small state, and we have direct access to our legislators. We can make a difference. We can make a difference simply by sending an email, simply by making a phone call, or supporting those that are supportive of our rights and the things that were important or that are important to us. So I see three, maybe even more, candidates on this call today that are running for legislature. If you want to raise your hand real quick, that would be great so we know who you are. I see you running for legislature this year. Cody, Timothy, Aaron, anybody else? Okay, so I just want to let you know that there are people out in this state, in this community, that are going to fight for your rights, but we need to vote them into office. We need to get them in those seats. There are so many people in Pierre who are, their time should be done. And so we are excited to know that our votes matter. I have a dear friend who's running this year for Senate, and she told me that 2 years ago when her opponent was running, he only won by less than 30 votes. And so there are like 30 people on this call. I mean, if we can rally our friends and our supporters together to get to the polls or vote by absentee ballot, we could really make a difference in who is in peer representing us, and we could get more people there that have our interests in mind and who do want better things for all South Dakotans. So I would encourage you not to just vote, but to get your friends, your family, everybody that you know excited about voting, and let them know that their one vote does make a difference. Now, I know that for trans people, voting at the polls is sometimes very anxiety inducing. And so one of the wonderful things that's going on this year is absentee voting. I think it's brilliant that we get to try it all out this year and see how it goes. But for a trans person who may not have their legal name or their documents changed, they may be stressed out by going to the polls. So I think this is going to be really helpful. One thing that I did learn this year from my phone, on my phone from a friend, is that you can scan documents from your notes app. Now, for those of you who need to get an absentee ballot, this is huge because your absentee ballot, in order to get that, you need to give them a copy of your driver's license or your identification. And so a lot of people are like, well, how do I do that? I don't have a copy machine. I don't have a printer. So all you do is you go to your notes app, and on your notes app, there's a little camera, and press that, and it actually scans documents for you. So you can scan it and then save it to your photos. And then take take it somewhere to print. You could go to like Lewis or FedEx, Kinko's, Office Depot, any of those places, or send it as an email and have a friend print it off for you. If you don't have a printer, go ahead and contact me at susan@transformationprojectsd.org, and we will hook you up. We want you to get your documents in order so that you are able to vote this year, because every vote matters. If you do have a trans friend in your life, encourage them to make their voice heard. If you do have anybody in the community that is an ally, let them know how important it is. Last year we had, I believe, 4 or 5 anti-trans bills brought about in the South Dakota legislature, and this needs to stop. So we need to get people in office who are going to vote those down and who are going to be on our side fighting for the rights of all individuals. So thank you for your time. So excited for Vote Out. We are voting out the people that need to be gone, and we are getting everybody out to vote. So thank you for being here today.
Thanks, Susan. That was wonderful. And just like with Cody, we're going to give away some more shirts. So 3 more people, Transformation Project shirts. You can rep this wonderful organization that does so many great things for people throughout the state of South Dakota. So Natasha, you pick 3 excited people. Maybe someone who's not paying attention.
I think I'm going to go with Brian because he has a cool Zoom background.
And, Hall of Justice. I thought that said Hogwarts. I didn't read, apparently.
And then Angelica because she has a cute cat. And and let's go with Aaron as well, just because I need, we'll do that one.
Perfect. So Jana will message you all. And again, she's a trustworthy ACLU representative. Please give her your information. We'll get you a shirt, or Susan will help you connect with that rather. And I'm gonna speak from the ACLU and talk a little bit about this campaign and why I care so much about voting and want you to as well. And after I'm done, you'll get one of our fancy new shirts. So that's pretty exciting. I think Susan and Cody really hit the nail on the head with what they said about getting out and voting and visibility and it being important. The people that we have in elected office throughout the state of South Dakota right now, many of them don't know about the issues that face our community. You know, some don't care and some openly advocate against people like us. And I know that we are all sick of it. I know that because we're all here. We all showed up today. Many of us in Sioux Falls showed up to the rally hosted by Sioux Falls Pride, which was wonderful. It's a great way to get us all together. Even during a pandemic, we proved that, you know, LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit people won't be held down and won't be silenced. And I think we need to carry that energy through to the ballot box, not just in November, but every single election after that. There are local elections happening throughout the state that aren't widely publicized online. So it is our duty to find those out where we live, pay attention to our school board elections, our city council elections, our county commissioner elections. One interesting office that I found out was elected was the coroner. Who knew? But even, you know, literally any job that's elected has an impact on your life in some way, in some fashion. And we want to make sure that those people that are elected are held accountable and are there for the right reasons. You know, we don't need to see bills like House Bill 1215 anymore. Legislative session doesn't have to be a battle every year. It doesn't have to be buses of people driving in the middle of a blizzard to advocate against bills that are chipping away at their right to exist. While I am impressed consistently every single day by everybody who advocates for their livelihood in South Dakota, I think we can all agree that it doesn't have to be a battle. There are issues facing communities, even outside of the LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit community, that aren't being addressed. You know, there's infrastructure that needs to be fixed. There are things that need to be done to help people thrive in South Dakota that are being ignored and thrown away because we're spending so much time battling these bills that are either unconstitutional, immoral, or unnecessary, or all of the above. Quite frankly, that's how you could sum up a lot of the anti-trans bills that we've seen. They're unnecessary, they're immoral, and they just harm people. So the purpose of this campaign is to really reconnect our power as queer people to change those things. We know that there is power at the ballot box, and we just have to show up. You can even vote from your own home, like Susan said. If you don't want to leave your house during a pandemic, or you're just an avid indoors person, you can vote from your own house. And we are happy to help people with printing things as well at the ACLU office. If you email us, if you don't have access to a printer, we can help you with those things. Also, I found out by saving the Secretary of State's office in my phone on speed dial, you can call them and they're more than happy to help you with any of your voting related questions. Or if you don't have access in home to a printer like me and many other people, they can mail you out the forms that you need. Chances are you might have to put a stamp on that to send it back. So please let us know or let an organization in your area know if you have trouble putting stamps on there. I know for me it was a struggle at first, but you can also drop those off at your county auditor's office, whatever forms you have that you're getting. So I'm very excited to see all of you on this call and then everybody on Facebook Live as well that I can't see currently, but I know there's some people, or at least I hope so. So I hope that what everybody takes away from this is, one, a sense of community. I know many, if not all, Pride events throughout the state where they're pushed to online or canceled because of COVID or postponed until later this year. So I hope that by seeing all of these faces, some familiar faces on Zoom, that you know that there are people in your community that care about you and that want you to be able to thrive. I don't want to see more queer people move out of South Dakota. We have so many things we can do to make this state so much better. And it makes my heart so happy to see people staying here, wanting to make a difference, and showing up to things like this online or rallies like what Sioux Falls Pride hosted this morning in person to push our elected officials to do better and hold them accountable in any way that they possibly can. One quick thing, if you need more information about the general voting process in South Dakota, we have a write-up that we've vetted over the last couple of months. So the information there is all pretty solid. It's on our website, aclusd.org/South Dakota Votes. So hopefully easy to remember. You can find that up there. We have links to different forms that you might need. And then many questions that people ask us are listed there as well, with solutions that are hopefully helpful to you. But with that, again, I wanna thank everyone for being here. Thank Natasha, thank Jana, Susan, Cody, everyone that's helped make this possible. We have a lot of good stuff coming. You know, this is just the launch. We're just letting everyone know that this is happening. Over the next couple of weeks, we're gonna be putting out information, hosting educational seminars online, possibly things in person if things shift with COVID. Who knows, it's all up in the air. And some pretty cool marketing materials. So watch out for what we're pushing out through these organizations. And how you can get informed and reconnect with your power as a voter. And consider signing up with our organizations as a volunteer or becoming a precinct worker in November. I did that for the primary election. It is a lot of fun. I know some people might not think that, you know, a 12-hour volunteer day is exciting, but it really is. So I encourage you to sign up for that. It's based by your county, but it is a paid position. So if you need to take time off of work, so hopefully that financial barrier is lessened by being compensated for your time. If you have any questions about that, I'm happy to chat through it with you or connect you with the right person for you to talk with. I'm a big fan of going directly to the source and getting questions answered immediately. So I'm gonna quit yapping and we'll get to giving away some more shirts. So Natasha, you wanna pick a couple folks?
Yeah, I think I'm going to pick some people that are hiding their faces this time. So yeah. Let's go with Bailey. We'll get a shirt. And am I just doing two or three?
Three.
Okay. And let's go with, let's go with Travis. Cause he's been here. He snuck in early, so he should probably. And then, we'll go with Amanda as well. Yeah, you.
Perfect. So each of you will get one of our SODAC Pride shirts that we made for Pride last year that we all wore in the parade, which was probably one of my favorite days ever, seeing thousands of people in downtown Sioux Falls showing up to celebrate LGBTQ plus and Two Spirit people. It was just very cool. So that's what we have for speakers. Thank you for listening to us. Hopefully that was empowering and insightful and educational for everybody who's tuning in. The last couple minutes here, we'll open up for some Q&A. So if anybody wants to unmute themselves, ask a question about either voting, vote outs, or our individual organizations, you can do that now. We'll save, you know, the next couple minutes, or you can throw your question into the chat.
Well, I'll start with a question, and I know there's a couple of you, I think, that said you were running for office, or we heard there were some people running for office on the call. You know, we're talking about, like, you know, getting some information from candidates. What is the best way to get that to get the information you want to know about candidates? You know, I know candidates put out a lot of information about themselves, but what if you want to find out specifics? What's the best way to do that?
Cody, Tim, I think Travis, you ran for office as well, if one of you want to answer.
So I'm down here in Vermilion, and I am on the city council. I didn't have to run like an actual election because the seat that was open, there were nobody else took out a petition. And so I kind of got to sidetrack the whole running for election and just got a nice little letter in the mail that said, congratulations, you're on the city council now. And that's actually a really interesting question that I am still working on. The best way for me to interact with like all of the people that I really want to hear from, and everybody, it's so important, especially like at this point in time, for me to really listen to like what people actually need. And so we have, I think we have a lot of us live in places like Vermilion or Sioux Falls or cities that are very hierarchical in how they work. And we have an attitude of like, oh, we're going to tell you what you need to make you happy. And I'm really, I really want to take an attitude of listening to what people actually need, and responding to that need. And I think each person is individual. Some people love to be on Facebook. Some people love to be on Twitter. You know, some people still send emails. So it's going to be really interesting to see the best way to reach out to people, but I'm excited for it.
Aaron or Cody, you want to jump in or can I hop on? Please excuse the extra audio. We're voting on party platform now, so I've got kind of a dual Zoom meeting going on. But to answer your question, Jana, I think most importantly is just being accessible as a candidate, kind of like Travis was saying, making sure that you have your due to outreach, especially during COVID right now, emailers, direct contact forms on your website. You know, personally, my phone number is personally listed, so you can reach out to me via Facebook Messenger, email, call me, text me. Just making sure that you're accessible as a legislator and that people can have a way to interact with you, to answer questions, to voice concerns, but also making sure that you have a clear platform and policy that's posted somewhere where people can quick glance and decide whether or not they feel like throwing support behind you is something that they can do, or if maybe they need to rethink and research some other candidates in the area. So I think a lot of it comes down to individually how each person is going to run their campaign. You know, a lot of these are local races, so you are going to have to kind of dig with a fine-tooth comb to figure out who it is that's in your district. And there's some great resources, like Adam was talking about, with the Secretary of State, who can connect you to where you're voted, where you're registered to vote at, where exactly your candidates are going to be, and who's on the ballot for you with the sample ballot. So doing that research, finding those candidates, it's seeing what platforms they have, and then ultimately sharing the word with other people so that you can help connect them like we're doing.
Thank you so much. Does anyone else have anything to add on to the, you know, getting the best information you can and getting in touch with candidates? I don't want to put anyone on the spot to make them answer if they don't want to, but all right, another question from the chat. With the COVID-19 pandemic going on, is the state of South Dakota going to encourage absentee voting for the general election in November?
I think I could speak to that a little bit. Obviously not as an employee of the state of South Dakota, but everyone has the opportunity to absentee vote or early vote starting September 18th, I believe. So you'll certainly have that opportunity to vote from home or to drop off your ballots at your county auditor's office instead of mailing it back, kind of whatever you prefer. But I would say to look into that with your county auditor to see the best process. I'm not sure if they're going to have as large of a push as they did for the primary, but do know that you have to apply to get an absentee ballot mailed to you if you didn't hit the all checkbox on the one that you did for the primary. But if anyone else has any more solid info from the state that they find out, please let us know. But I think that's what I know right now.
And I think to add on to that too, I guess, you know, absentee voting, early voting is definitely something that's always available in South Dakota. So if, you know, it's your comfort level with the pandemic, if you want to go to the polls, you know what, great, go to the polls if they're going to be open. If you feel more comfortable submitting your ballot by mail, then you know what? Go do it. It's just the most important thing is to cast that ballot and vote. So, All right, here, another, it's kind of a comment from the chat box, but Liz was looking for more information on helping out at the poll. So Adam, I thought maybe you could address that as well, just to everybody. What do you do if you're interested?
Definitely. So if you want to become a precinct worker, I recommend getting in touch with your local county auditor. You can also call the South Dakota Secretary of State's website. I'll put that information in the chat and in our Facebook comments after this, because I just have to pull it off of our website. But it was a pretty slick process when I signed up. I just emailed Minnehaha County Auditor, talked to Bob Litz, who's our county auditor, back in December. So I started pretty early. By no means do you have to do that, but you could. If you're an early person like me, I'm always very chronically early to things. But they recruit, you know, hundreds of people every election. And I think they're looking for more hands to help them in November. It is a fairly long day. I think it was there for about 14 hours, something like that. You'll do a training that's about 90 minutes. Then you'll do a setup the day before, which I found out was a little new this year. In previous years, I've heard they did it the night before. But there's usually someone there that can help you go through the process if you're a first-time precinct worker like I was. But it's a pretty fun day, actually, because everyone's coming in to cast their ballot and make their voices heard. So you're just there to make sure the process is easy for them. It's extremely nonpartisan. So you're not to talk about any candidate or your position on things. You're just getting them the information and helping them cast their ballot. And being very detailed and just confirming things with them when you're going through lists and things like that. But yeah, I encourage you just to call your county auditors, talk to them, email them, and be persistent also. I did that just to make sure that they knew I was interested. So if you email them, say this week, touch base again in a couple weeks just to make sure they have your information so that you're prepared for November 3rd. Because I think it's about, you know, 6 a.m. to 8 p.m., but it's a fun day. And people usually bring snacks. There's like a strong sense of community there. It's a really fun time, and I highly recommend anybody that's on this call or anybody that's tuning in or really anybody that hasn't done it before to give it a try. It's fun.
All right. I don't see any more questions in the chat. If anybody's got one, you know, speak now or forever hold your peace. No, just kidding. You can always contact anyone at the ACLU and we will get back to you with questions. But barring any other questions, you know, this is going to sound a little cheesy, but I would like to take a full, like a group picture of everybody and their smiling faces in the gallery view. So if you don't have your video on and you want to pop your video on, please, please do. And I'm gonna do a print screen of everybody's faces just for fun. This is one of those, like, it's kind of cheesy, but we're just gonna have fun with it, right? So give me a couple seconds here and I'll get ready to print screen. All right, everybody smile. 1, 2, 3. All right, thank you for indulging me. That's kind of a mom moment, right? All right, I will turn it back over to Adam, I think, for some closing remarks.
Yeah, thanks, Jana. And thank you, everybody, for partaking in our group picture. I warned a couple of you ahead of time, so you knew that was coming, but to some, it was a surprise. So thank you for indulging us in that. Thank you again for being on this call. I think we had about 50 or 60 people register to tune in to get more information. So hopefully that means there's about 60 more people across the state of South Dakota that are more deeply engaged in the political process. Our vote only matters when we show up, or only counts when we show up. So make sure that either you're voting in person November 3rd, voting early starting in September, or helping people get to the polls if you've already voted, and educating your friends and your neighbors on the importance of making their voice heard this election, and just doing all that you can to lift your story as either a queer person or an ally. Because it's important, you know, we can change the political landscape in South Dakota, but it all just starts by showing up at the ballot box, reconnecting our power as voters, and then bringing everyone else into the fold. We can't do this alone. So I'm thankful to see so many faces on here. We got a fight ahead of us, but I believe that we can all do it together. So that's all that I have. Feel free to email any of us at our organizations or visit our websites if you want more information. Let's maybe close it with like another song and then boogie on out of here and enjoy the rest of our Saturdays. It looks like the weather is finally clearing up. So that's
wonderful. In the chat, someone had mentioned Chromatica and it rained this morning for their visit. Thing. So I think we have to do Rain on Me, right? Like
I think that's appropriate.
I didn't ask for a free ride. I only asked you to show me a real good time. I never asked for the rainfall. At least I showed up. You showed me nothing at all. It's coming down.
That's it, everyone. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. We're right at an hour, about actually 56 minutes. So my timing is spot on. Glad you all could join us. I put some information in the chat. I'll also put it in comments on Facebook. And we're going to post this video later. So if you want to relive this moment, you certainly may. But we hope to see you all in the future soon, either on Zoom or in person as we can. Again, thank you so much. Appreciate you all for reinstilling a sense of hope in me as a queer South Dakotan, that we're all in this together. Appreciate you.
Thanks, Adam.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.